Welcome back to Indian Trace. I've been doing some displays lately, as many of you have seen, and really I thank you for the responses that give me, you know, some direction in making these. Now, if you're used to seeing mine, you're seeing something different, because I might title this "Not This Time," because what you're not seeing, I'll just put it that way, is you're not seeing rhyolite, and you're not seeing quartz. Eastern North Carolina, we also have other indigenous rock that was here that I can't even identify, and some of my buddies can't even identify, but this is it right here. I just grabbed some stuff up from my bottom bins, just pulling pieces here or there. This is just a sampling. I mean, this is not all of it, and I'll probably entitle it "Not This Time," because this is, I don't even know what kind of material to call it, but what I know it is this beautiful. I mean, these are incredible artifacts. Check this out. Just take this still shot out, and maybe pause it, just so you can see this all together. It's unbelievable, but I'm going to show you a close-up of these, because this is just worth seeing. I mean, look at this, just in little sections, and then we're going to really check it out. But like I said, the bottom bins of my display box, I keep this type of material. And I know in majority what I usually talk about and show is my rhyolite and the quartz that I found. And it's not that I don't like this type of material, because you find just as many artifacts made out of it. It just never got around to it. There's just a lot to show. So let's go ahead and do that. Look at this point right here. Found this at the lookout. It just turned out to be a really great point. And you will see the uniqueness and difference between this material and the rhyolite and quartz we're used to seeing. Still, for those who are just tuning in, this is Eastern North Carolina, and I just wanted to be able to show you some of these points outside the realm of, I guess you would say, rhyolites. And this stuff all has its accents of red and tan, and most of it's gray. Almost all of it has speckles. Look at this point. Unbelievable, right? Anyway, most all of it is sort of speckled. And because I don't know what type of material it is, I want to share it. And just give you a good look at it. All I know, it's rock that they figured out how to work. And, you know, when we come across it, we're just pretty much like, well, I'll take that. And you just collect it and you just keep moving on. But when it starts to repeat and you start to come across material that's very similar to one another, you go ahead and gather it up. I mean, look at these two points. Different accents and the color, but the material is very similar. Here's a Marl Mountain, real nice point from the dunes. The dunes is the culprit. The dunes is where I got the green tobacco sickness a couple weeks ago. It's a crazy place. Nice point though, right there. This came from Notchville. If this were wet, it would take on a sort of reddish material. What's really neat about a lot of these, and you can see these, is that, now I would say, even in we're going to see pieces like this, that to me they're perfect. They're full of character, full of personality. Many you might look at and say, well, that's a perfect arrowhead. Maybe no such thing. Maybe no such thing. But these is a great group. I mean, look at this piece right here. Unique for around here, and that's for sure. Good lineup.
I'm going to try to do something here with the layout and just take a little bit of time. I'm starting to get used to what kind of time I have to show these so that they make a display that's different and unique. Just to give you a good show. These are all about 2 inches here, and then we move to about 1.25 inches. Look at these pieces. What's this piece right here? Nice notch piece. This came from Coyote Pass. I remember this. And what I want you to do as you look at these with me is focus on the material. There's so many different styles for sure. Love the notch points here. But so many different styles. Just check out the material though. And remember what I usually show. Straight rhyolite, straight quartz. These are particularly different. Sorry, I'm giving some dead camera space. Let me try to adjust that as we go along here. Nice piece. All right, let's look at this. Unique piece from the Rise. Just like it, like it's for its material. Another piece right here. It's funny because this is from the Rise as well. I mean, look at these two pieces. Interesting thought, right? Put those up there. Let me get a couple more pieces here and variate it. And even me right now, looking at these, it's very strange because I haven't seen them in a long time and I'm so used to seeing a lot of rhyolite. And this stuff definitely is not. So let me let the material speak for itself as we look at these. Of course, this came from Hardstone. I mean, that's over right next to Mecca. Just strong North American Indian artifacts. I like this point right here. This has a lot of great qualities to it. I don't know if my focus is working as good as I want it to all the time. All right, good stuff. Now look at this. We got a little bit more left here, but it's incredible. The very different, unique type of materials here. That's a nice point. So far. For those of you who are in or around Louisiana, I hope you're doing okay. That flood was crazy. And forgive me for my insensitivity. When I first heard it was raining, I'm like, well, great, you guys get a bunch of rain and be able to find some artifacts. It's beyond that now, as we all know. And my hopes for your safety and your family's safety. Some great stuff here. Let me take a couple right here and just look at them. Sort of featuring today all materials that is definitely not rhyolite or quartz, of course. Unique point right here. Little bit of a Guilford straight base here from Hidden Alley. Just taking some time in the ancient life this afternoon. I went out, but I really didn't find a whole lot, so I figured, hey, no videos out, I'm gonna make a couple videos in. And it's worth passing the time. We're sharing a little bit of this stuff that's never seen. I told somebody in text, you know, maybe once a year I'm happy to share this stuff. Here's one I found at Smoke Alley. It just grew on me. Material matches, so it all goes in the same bin. A lot of this comes from a couple bins, about the same bins, but not the exact same place. Not today. Today I was just going to pull from a bunch of bins that had this type of material that you're seeing here. The relation of very interesting looking material. Look at that. It's good stuff. Then a nice point right here. It's pretty clear that they really just took what, you know, what would work for them and what would get the job done and what they could craft and handle, which is really cool. Now, we got some stuff up here as we finish out. Just keeps going, you know. It'll just keep coming in and out of the earth. There's so much ancient Indian life in the earth. Look at this unique point. Found from Mecca, right at the top of Stone Hill. If I can show you, it does have a relief right up the middle. Don't know if the shadow will catch it. It's a nice point. As always, I really just appreciate a bunch of you who tune in here and are able to see some different artifacts that they don't get to see that often. And as the time keeps clicking by here, I've got to hurry. I can see that it just goes fast. I'm trying to show you both sides and sort of doing some double up on similar styles. I guess a couple great big Sandies right here. Good points. So, if you're with me and you just love what the North American Indian artifacts speak of, a culture that's gone by, and, I mean, look at those are sweet, aren't they? That we're trying to grasp and catch up with, that we're trying to understand a little more about. Here's another couple points. The one on the right is from Hidden Hill, and the one on the left is from Windy Point. Some great stuff. Well, if you do, then this stuff, these kind of videos here will never bore you. If they do, of course, don't watch. I always say that. It's funny. You know, what the heck, you know, I just try to put it out there. And I know there are some that really appreciate getting to see this stuff that they never get to see. And certainly some of you, you know, and I hate it, don't ever get to find it. I think you should. And as I finish up here, I'm looking at my time and following it. I don't want to get cut off on my memory here. This right here is a flat out group. I mean, look at this group. And I didn't take time at all to grab this up out of the box. Very similar material, very different than usual. And as we just do a little bit of a flyby by row, we'll have to go in sets. It's just fantastic stuff. The projectile points of the North American Indian here in eastern North Carolina. Since this is not, I'm not going to let this go over 15, I just want to say thank you for tuning in to Indian Trace and just for all the great comments and conversations. It's a good community. And right there, man, that's a good view of it right there. I think I'll leave it at that. And all in all, when you're getting out there and the fall comes, I hope you guys find some stuff and, you know, show everybody what you got. Have a good one.